Okay, hello cloud gurus, how y'all doing? I'm Scott Pletcher, back with more AWS news goodness. But first, before we get into the news, we need you, specifically your opinion. You see, we want to fill our YouTube channel with all sorts of content that you just absolutely love. And the best way we know how to figure that out is to ask. So please take a moment to fill out our little survey link down below. Your input is so very valuable, and it'll let us create more of what you want to see. All right, on with the news. Lift and shift just got a bit easier. Deploying containers for fun and profit gets more accessible, and we have some massive new EC2 instances to be sure we don't accidentally leave running in our dev accounts. All right here on AWS This Week. Sometimes AWS has an uncanny ability to take a relatively simple service and make it hilariously complex. I'm looking at you, Route 53. But on the flip side, AWS has been able to greatly simplify some very complex tasks. SageMaker Autopilot and AWS Amplify come to mind here. We now have another complex made simple service to add to the list, AWS App Runner. App Runner is a fully managed container application service that lets people deploy and run containerized web apps and APIs without any prior container experience. It's kind of like Elastic Beanstalk, but for containers, and all the infrastructure and orchestration is handled for you automatically behind the scenes. So if you've been wanting to get into the container game with all the other cool kids, but just didn't know how to start, App Runner might be worth a look. Many companies would dearly love to migrate all their existing on-prem servers to the cloud, but might be hesitant, especially with mission-critical applications, given the complexity and risk. AWS has released a new service that might be able to make that migration path a little more palatable. AWS Application Migration Service is an evolution of the CloudEndure offerings and the server migration service, and is now the recommended way to lift and shift all those servers. It starts with installing a replication agent on the source server that will sync data at the block level to an EBS volume. You can then use the console to test the cutover process until you're confident everything is working as it should. If you have some mission critical servers that you're just too scared to touch, let alone to migrate, the new application migration service might help you out there. Recently, AWS announced some new monster size high memory instance types for when you just need maximum RAM. We can now provision instances with 6, 9, or 12 terabytes of random access memory. Yes, you heard me right, 12 terabytes. Now, these are virtual machines and not metal instances, and they can be run on demand or under a savings plan if you happen to have one of those things. Why on earth would you need something with this much RAM? One reason is in-memory databases. SAP's HANA database is a good example of such a thing. And because the data is stored in RAM, it's wicked fast. Because of that speed, companies have been able to use the same HANA instance for both OLTP and OLAP use cases, meaning they can get real-time analytics directly against live transactional data, eliminating the need to offload and aggregate that data into a separate data warehouse. The 12 terabyte instance will set you back around $109 per hour, and they're available now in Northern Virginia, Ireland, Frankfurt, and Singapore regions. That, my friends, is all the AWS news that's fit to print this week. Stay safe, take care of one another, and keep being awesome, cloud gurus.